Hi dear students, today I am going to continue the second chapter, that is principles of management. So yesterday class, last class we have studied about the what is the meaning of principles, principle of management and the nature of principles of management. So today we are going to study about the what are the importance of principles of management, or we can say it as a significance of principles of management. So actually this importance is to be understand when you are going to study about the two persons principles of management, that we can say as a Hankey-Fields or scientific management and Taylor's principles of management. So let us see how the principles are to be plays an important role in every business organization. So importance, or we can say as a significant or significance of principles of management. So there are mainly six importance are there. So let us start from first, that is providing managers with useful insights into reality, then optimum utilization of resources and effective administration, then scientific decisions, meeting changing environment requirements, fulfilling social responsibilities, management, training, education and research. So these are the six importance of principles of management. So first importance says that providing managers with useful insights into reality. Here you can say whatever the managers are there in every business organization, if the management or the managers follow the principles, whatever the rules, regulations, norms, values are to be framed by practice and experimentation, if they are going to follow the principles, then they will provide with useful insights into reality. Means here we can say as a real. So when you are going to apply the, or when you are going to follow the principles in business organization, then the managers are able to make the real facts. Means they can give the accurate result when they are going to follow the principles of management. So we can say it plays a very important role. So principles of management having one of the importance that managers will provide useful insights into reality. So whatever the information they are going to provide, or when they are going to follow the principles, while following the principles there is be useful insights which we can provide into a reality. So we can say as a there will be a real facts, there will be the facility of reality. So we can say there will be availability of reality when we follow the principles of management. So whatever the frame principles are there, whatever the rules and regulations are there, if the manager are going to follow them, then he can easily go through the reality. Okay, so next one, that is optimum utilization of resources and effective administration. So here we can say optimum utilization is nothing but what? Best utilization. Best utilization of resources and effective administration. Effective administration means here we can save the wastage of resources. So here we can say optimum utilization of resources is nothing but when the managers are going to follow the principles, then automatically it is useful to best utilization of resources. Optimum means best utilization of resources. Whatever the resources are available in business organization, that resources are to be used in a correct manner. So optimum utilization is very important. So when you are going to follow the principles, then only they can use the resources in a correct way. That we can say as a optimum utilization of resources. And effective administration. Effective administration is nothing but all in every department, the administration is to be handled in a correct manner. Means administration is to be handled in a correct manner in the sense what? It reduces the wastages. Whatever, for example, we can say if in a production department, if the raw materials are to be wasted in a more number of wastages are to be made, then it should be reduced. So you can use effectively. So whatever the activities you are going to do, you should be effective. So on the basis of effective administration means we have to reduce the wastages or reduce the cost expenditures which is to be made helpful to development. So it is only possible when you are going to follow the principles. So on the basis of following the principles of management, it is more helpful to make the resources in a best way, to make the utilization of resources in a best way, and also to reduce the wastages or any other cost incurred in the business organization, which is make an effective management or effective administration. So you can say here it plays a very important role. Why? Because it is more helpful to make the utilization of resources in a best way. With this you can say as a, it reduces the expenditures or any other cost or wastages which is incurred in the administration. So it is more helpful to make the effective administration. So this is the second importance of principles of management. So next one is scientific decision. So here when you are going to make the or take the work from the employees, here one principle will say that division of work. When you are going to divide the work to all the employees, here we can say it is also an effective of administration only. When you are going to divide the work to the employees, then it is easily take the work effectively. So you can say division of work also plays a very important role, which is one of the principle. Okay, so here scientific decision, when you are going to make the decisions in a business organization, in every department, if the manager is having a position to take the decisions, scientific decisions are to be valued, or we can say there is a scientific decisions are plays a very important role. So in previous class we studied the nature of principles of management. In that we have studied about the cause and effect. So cause and effect is nothing but what? When you are going to put the effort, then only then we can say as a, if you are going to do the hard work, that is called as the cause. After putting the hard work, then you will get the good result, that is effective. So on that basis only it is dependent, that is scientific decision. Scientific decision is nothing but what? Cause and effect. Why? Because when you are going to follow the rules and regulations, or when you are going to follow the principles, then only your work will be effective. Then you can take the scientific decisions easily. So on that basis you can say it is a plays a very important role. Okay, that is scientific decision, cause and effect. Why? Because if you are going to follow the principles, then it is easy to take the decisions. Okay, next that is meeting changing environment requirements. So environment requirements, whatever the requirements are there. So if it is related to environment requirements are there, means it helps to make the changes. When you are going to follow the principles, as per the rules and regulations, if there will be a flexibility, flexibility is nothing but as per the conditions, as per the situations, you are going to make the modification of principles or modification of some rules and regulations. So on that basis it affects on the environment. So on that basis we can say that meeting changing environment requirements, when you are going to follow the principles, as per the situation, the there will be the changes in the environment. So whatever the requirements are to be there, environment requirements are to be there, as per the principles, you are going to follow the principles, as per the situation you are going to make the changes, or you have to helpful to the modifications in that particular situation. So on that basis we can say meeting changing environment requirements. So whatever the requirements are there, environmental requirements, so suppose we can say as a, if employees having their own requirements, if you are going to fulfill their requirements, then it plays a very important role. Why? Because if you are fulfilling the requirements of the employees, then they will do the correct work. Why? Because if you are understanding the feelings or understanding the problems of the employees, then automatically you can fulfill the requirements, or you can fulfill their wants, then they can easily do the work effectively. So on that basis, if you are making, if there is a necessary to change the certain requirements, then it is helpful with the help of principles. Only when we are going to follow the principles of management. Okay. So next one is fulfilling social responsibility. So here we can say that, for example, employees demands, wants, requirements. So here fulfilling social responsibility. Social responsibility in the sense what? Not only for related to society, even internal sources also. Internal means who are working in the organization. If you are going to fulfill their requirements, then it is helpful to make the fulfill the social responsibility. When going to fulfill the demands, wants, and whatever the solutions of the problems related of the employees, then it is automatically fulfilling the social responsibility. So this is also one of the importance of or significance of principles of management. So we can say fulfilling the social responsibility is more helpful with the help of principles. Why? Because when I'm going to use or when I'm going to follow the principles, then while following the principles, whatever the framed principles are there, whatever the principles are to be derived in the particular business organization, by following that principles, we can fulfill the social responsibilities. Social responsibility we can take as an example of employees' requirements or employees' demands, wants. If you are going to fulfilling them, then automatically you can take as a responsibility whatever manager has to do. Next is management training, education and research. So with the help of following the principles, management can provide the employees training, education and research. When you are going to follow the principles, then management can helpful to the laborers or to the employees to provide a training facility should be provided before doing the work. What they have to do, how they have to do, how the resources are to be utilized, then how to give the information them by providing the training facility. So when you are doing the training, how to use the machineries, by providing the training, they can use the or use optimum utilization of resources. Then only it is more helpful. So on that basis, management will provide training for the employees. Not only training, they will provide the education facility. Education in the sense what? They have to give the knowledge of a particular task. Then they provide the education and so they will be helpful for the research. Research in the sense what they are going to train, what they are getting the knowledge. On that basis, they will do the research. So these three things are to be provided by the management when the management is going to follow the principles. When the managers or the supervisors, when they are going to follow the principles of management, they will be able to provide the training facility, education facility and research facility with the help of management. So management are capable to do the, or they will be provided the training facility, education and research to the employees. Why? Because if they will give the training or if they are going to do the education, research, then they can easily be confident that to do the work in a correct way and they can be able to reach the objective of the business organization. So on that basis, we can say that principles of management plays a very important role. So we can say as an importance of principles of management or significance of principles of management plays a very important role. Why? Because first we have studied that first significance says that it helps the managers by providing the reality. Whatever the principles we are going to study, if that it is more helpful for to come into the reality. Next, optimum utilization of resources and effective administration. So here we are going to follow the principles, then it is easily make the best utilization of resources in business organization, as well as it reduces and reduces the wastages or reduces the cost to make the administration in a good way, and that we can say as a effective. Then scientific decisions, which we can make the decisions easily with the help of principles, and we can take a correct decisions by cause and effect. Next, meeting changing environment requirements. If there is any necessary, then you can modify the some norms. If there is necessary, then only then you can make the changes in the environment requirements. Then fulfilling the social responsibility, if you are fulfilling the demands, wants, whatever the requirements of the employees are there, if you are going to fulfilling them, then automatically your business will be run in a good way. Then as well that when you are going to follow the principles, management will be provide training facility, education facility and research facility to the employees. So that we can say by following the principles, your business will be going in a smooth way and it is more helpful to run a business and it may be helpful for the development of your business organization. Okay, so today we have studied about the significance of principles of management. Okay.